Radhe Radhe, welcome to Hinduism Q&A. Today's question is, what are yogic siddhis? In other words, what are transcendental or psychic powers? In fact, these are material powers that lie dormant in the mind of every person. We have deeper and deeper levels to our mind, from our conscious mind to our subconscious mind, to our unconscious mind, to our fully unconscious mind. So as one adopts yogic practices, the pure yogic practices as described by sage Patanjali, and one practices the meditation of the path of yoga and maintains the renunciation required on the path of yoga, we're able to transcend to deeper and deeper levels of consciousness. So these yogic siddhis are awakened as we reach those certain levels of consciousness. Therefore, the awakening of these siddhis, which could include things like clairvoyance, clairaudience, these are very lower level siddhis. And then the higher siddhis would enable a person to even defy gravity, float in the air, disappear from one place and appear somewhere else, what we call teleportation, make their body as small as an atom or as big as a mountain, as light as a feather, or so heavy that nothing could lift your body. So the yogi actually develops powers to manipulate the physical elements of creation. These psychic powers or yogic powers, however, are only material powers. They're not divine powers. They're not related to God in any way. And in fact, sage Patanjali says, samadha vupasarga vyutthane siddhayah. These siddhis that are awakened through the practice of Ashtanga Yoga, they are awakened by practicing samadhi, by practicing the transcendental practices of yoga. However, they are upasarg. They are actually obstacles on the path because they are material allurements. We feel pride in getting this power and we want to use this power. So the more a yogi uses such a power, the more prideful they become and the more their actual progress begins regressing. So by using the powers, they lose their progress. So these yogic siddhis are in fact meant to be seen as landmarks, but they're not meant to be indulged in. If such a person exists in the world who has these powers and is exhibiting them, showing them to other people, then this is the sure path of their downfall from their spiritual progress. And anyone who gets attracted by such a person is also getting attracted in the wrong direction. The true path to God is about humbleness and is about loving remembrance of God. It has nothing to do with psychic powers. So this is a real thing that exists. There's a whole realm of psychic powers and experiences, but it's all within the realm of Maya, and it keeps us in the cycle of birth and death. If we wish to transcend even that, then we have to dedicate ourselves wholeheartedly to a personal form of God through the path of bhakti. Jai Shri Radhe.